Iowa Catholic Radio presents the Daily Mass from St. Francis of Assisi Catholic Church in West Des Moines. Father Joseph Pins, pastor. Father John Broby, associate pastor.
We offer this Mass for Patricia Saylor. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. To prepare ourselves to celebrate this sacred mystery, let us call to mind our sins.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Look upon your family, Lord, that through the chastening effects of bodily discipline, our minds may be radiant in your presence with the strength of our yearning for you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within each of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down and do not return there till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. From all their distress, God rescues the just. From all their distress, God rescues the just. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol his name. I sought the Lord, and he answered me, and delivered me from all my fears. From all their distress, God rescues the just. Look to him that you may be radiant with joy, and your faces may not blush with shame. When the poor one called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress he saved him. From all their distress, God rescues the just. The Lord has eyes for the just and ears for their cry. The Lord confronts the evildoers to destroy remembrance of them from the earth. From all their distress, God rescues the just. When the just cry out, the Lord hears them, and from all their distress, he rescues them. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted, and those who are crushed in spirit, he saves. From all their distress, God rescues the just.
One does not live by bread alone, but on every word that comes forth from the mouth of God. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, in praying, do not babble like the pagans, who think that they will be heard because of their many words. Do not be like them. Your Father knows what you need before you ask him. This is how you are to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. If you forgive men their transgressions, your heavenly Father will forgive you. But if you do not forgive men, neither will your Father forgive your transgressions. The Gospel of the Lord.
The readings of today probably explains the 1% challenge. I take that again. The readings of the day explain to all of us the 1% challenge. The Word of God sometimes is presented to us in symbols. In Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 29, it is presented as fire and hammer. The Word of God is like fire and hammer. In James chapter 1, verse 23 following, it is presented as a mirror. When you look into the Word of God, you see who you are in His presence. Again, my dearly beloved, in Psalm 119, verse 103, the Word of God is presented as honey. The Word of God is sweeter than honey. It is something that is sweet. Verse 105, the Word of God is like a light and a lamp. The Word of God, my dearly beloved, in the Gospels is presented as seeds. Seed that is sown, which must grow and bear fruit. In our first reading from Isaiah chapter 55, verse 10 following, the Word of God is presented as rain and snow. Rain and snow. Maybe if I were in Ghana, or while I was in Ghana, I didn't know what snow was. Now I know what snow is. And so this text comes alive because now I know what rain is and I know what snow is. I remember having a conversation with Mark, and he was telling me how they needed some snow so bad so that the soil would be fertile and be ready for the following year's, you know, farming. Now, my dearly beloved, the Word of God is like snow and rain. When they come down, they don't go up. They must water the soil so that when we grow our crops, our seeds, they will sprout and then they will bear fruits. Now, in 1% challenge, we water our lives. The Word of God, even as we come face to face in that Lectio Divina, divine reading, it is like watering our lives with rain and snow. When our hearts become fertile ground and we read the Word of God, encounter God Himself in His Word, my dear people of God, we begin to bear fruit. The fruit of love. It is impossible to bear that fruit without a divine encounter in His Word. You can only bear fruit when you encounter God in His Word. And that is when you experience the overflow of rain and snow. I don't think we need any more snow. But my dear beloved, in our lives as Christians and in the 1% challenge, we call down rain and snow. That which is spiritual and that which enables us to grow in our faith. It is amazing how many people have embraced the 1% challenge. As at last night, the people who had embraced it have given us 399 days of prayer in St. Francis Church. Can you imagine? In this season of Lent, all of us put together, we already have 399 days of prayer going out, going in the heavens for the people of St. Francis and for our parish and for all our mission. And then the gospel reading, my dearly beloved, will give us the pattern of prayer. Every prayer has 5 P's. And these 5 P's are presented in the Lord's Prayer, the Our Father. Anytime you pray that prayer, you have the 5 P's of prayer. The first P of prayer is praise. And that happens in the Lectio Divina. You praise God, you thank God, you bless God, you lift his name on high for all that he has done in our lives. And then there is the second P, which is petition. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy will be done, your kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. That is petition. And then you move on to pardon. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Then there is provision. Give us this day our daily bread. Provision, the basic need of humanity. And that, my dearly beloved, is represented in bread. Give us this day our daily bread. And that is why it is only Italians who understand this prayer more than anyone else. Because every meal comes with bread. Pane quotidiane, our daily bread. And then finally, there is the last P, which is protection. Lead us not into temptation and deliver us from evil. So the five P's of prayer, which we encounter in the 1% challenge, in the Lectio Divina, is praise, petition, pardon, provision, and protection. If you will have all these, within 15 minutes, why will you not sacrifice 15 minutes of your life every day asking God to meet you at the point of your various needs? If you have not accepted the challenge yet, you still have some time. Please accept the challenge and let us encounter God in his word. Shall we rise and trust in that our God is able to provide, present our petitions before him?
For members of the church throughout the world, may the outpouring of the Holy Spirit sanctify each one of us in our daily lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For national and civic leaders, may the Holy Spirit empower them in serving their people as Christ came to serve. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor, may God save them from their distress and provide for their every need. Let us pray to the Lord. For this worship community, may the Eucharist strengthen us as we work to build God's kingdom on earth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially for Patricia Seller, may God soon welcome them into the kingdom, eternal kingdom of heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those prayers that are in the depths of our hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
That prayer will become our lifestyle, and for the people of Syria, for the people of Turkey, and for the people of Ukraine. Let us ask our Mother Mary to intercede on our behalf as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And we make all our prayers through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness you have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness you have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive, O Creator, Almighty God, what we bring from your bountiful goodness, and be pleased to transform this temporal sustenance you have given us, that it may bring us eternal life through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending now your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that it may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together, Francis, our Pope, and William Johnson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Patricia Saylor, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that she was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in each of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant their peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Let us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Jesus, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us through these mysteries, Lord, that by moderating earthly desires, we may learn to love the things of heaven through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May your faithful be strengthened, O God, by your blessing. In grief, may you be their consolation. In tribulation, their power to endure, and in peril, their protection, through Christ our Lord. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Have a wonderful day.
You've been listening to the Daily Mass from St. Francis of Assisi Catholic Church in West Des Moines on the Iowa Catholic Radio Network.